In healthcare, there are plenty of things that we know. We know that one easy step towards preventing infection is to wash your hands. We know that oxygen containers and open flame just don't mix. We know the average cost of a hospital cafeteria salad is $6.24. And we know that if every healthcare worker were to sing together at the same time, we would be heard on the moon. All right, we don't know that. There are, in fact, much less absurd things that we don't know. We don't know the true and complete costs of specific procedures. How much does double bypass truly cost? We don't know. How much does it cost to treat an eye infection? Also, we don't know, but we could, and we should. This is where patient costing comes in. Sometimes it's called case costing. Patient costing, or case costing, is an accounting method that captures the full cost of specific procedures and episodes of care by calculating all direct and indirect costs. Consider a hip replacement. What are the costs associated with that procedure? Some costs spring to mind immediately. These are the costs of patient care before, during, and after the procedure. There are drug costs, x-ray and other imaging costs, specialized equipment costs, lab costs, and more. And then there are the administration, records, and housekeeping costs, the patient meals, the costs of simple comforts in the room, as well as costs like heat and light. The price tag of the actual replaced hip is only a starting point. Knowing all of this information through patient costing is of great value. Accurate information helps in making the best possible decisions. It provides a guide for analysis, comparison, and evaluation. It lets us compare approaches and procedures among regions. For example, a procedure done at one hospital may cost more than a similar one done at another hospital across the country. But if the patient from the first procedure recovers twice as quickly, it might be money well spent. Only a complete picture can reveal all the information, and this knowledge can be used to determine best practices. And it can help healthcare leaders and providers evolve from working from a situation where we think to one in which we know. There are three main elements that enable patient costing. The first is to ensure the data we collect fits within the Management Information System standards in Canadian Health Service Organizations of the Canadian Institute for Health Information. These standards ensure we're collecting data consistently in a way that will allow healthcare centers to compare apples to apples, so to speak. The second is a workload measurement system to assess where time is spent and what activities are undertaken so that resources can be allocated to best meet patient care needs now and in the future. And the third is the process of turning all of this data into workable information. With patient costing in place, we have three principal desired outcomes. The first outcome is improved patient care. Patient costing provides information that helps to make the best patient care and health system decisions. The second is accountability. Knowing full costs of procedures and episodes of care allows us to be more transparent and accountable. The third is sustainability. The more spending escalates, the greater the pressure on our ability to sustain healthcare services. And patient costing will help us find the most efficient ways to work. Implementing patient costing, or case costing, is a step towards meeting the challenges we all face in healthcare as healthcare leaders and providers and citizens with better information to make better, more informed decisions.